at that time when I first got married, I live in a one bedroom house.
Okay.
Okay, as in one bedroom in a house.
Yeah.
So that's how poor
one
we were.
Yes. In Australia.
In Australia. And then when I run the business at its peak, I bought apartments and I end up living in a 6,000 square feet penthouse.
Wow.
That's how well the business took me.
Yeah.
Okay. And then I lost it all again.
Okay.
Because of bankruptcy. And even my apartment here, I have to lease it out. My family was living on $200 a week. And we're a family of five. Okay. So you know how little that is.
Yeah, yeah.
So we cut back on so many things and suffered because of the business and because of the people we hire throughout the business. So that's what people don't understand. When you work for an entrepreneur, the liability on an entrepreneur is so much bigger than an employee. When they leave, they move on. But the owner suffers.
Yeah, yeah.
So we paid the price in 2015. And then in 2015, I came home. I remember it when I was bankrupt in December. And my mother asked me the first question, of course. She's going to ask me, so what are you going to do now? Okay? And knowing me, my mother knows me so well. Of course, my answer is, I'm going to build another business. And my mom goes, did you not just understand the lesson of the market? I say, it's even better that I lost a lot, because then that means the lessons are bigger. I will learn the lessons and then I will do my next venture carefully. And I won't fail again. Nobody purposely drive their business into bankruptcy. You must remember that. We have so much love for the thing we do, that the thing that brings us to losses are things that's beyond our control. Like human, like investment, we cannot see return. Nothing is guaranteed in business. So we paid the price and I told my mother, this time I'm going to build more safety nets and my new business venture, it's going to thrive because of the lessons I learned during bankruptcy.
Nice. Yes.
Didn't give up for 18 months, stubborn as hell. My mother gave up on me at some point. 18 months didn't make money. Yeah, yeah, only, you know, they do a business now. I'm gonna do tech. Da, da, da. 18 months, absolutely no money, owing my mother money, had to rent up my HDB. So, in the end, I'm asking myself every day for 18 months, why am I still here? Why am I still waking up?
Was that the lowest point of your
that
life?
That was 2015 was the worst year in my life.
So, you are bankrupt and then you go 2 years without any profit and borrowing people?
Yes, so 18 months.
All right.
Of course, there's always an option if you want to eat and live by is to work 8 hours a day for someone else. But an entrepreneur is an entrepreneur, okay? So I've seen how well this business feed me. I do not believe that it will not be able to take me up again. I don't believe that. So the journey is very emotional for me. So I told people for 18 months, and at first people believe you, okay, maybe you're going to be fine. After 18 months, nobody believes you anymore. You still don't have money, you're still nobody, nobody's investing in you, your business is still nothing. And my mother is asking me this question, why are you still building this platform? And this platform, I tell you a little bit, okay, Cairo, this platform is a very smart platform. Okay, and I tell you why, because it brings meanings to people's life. You, say a stay-home mom in Indonesia, needs to earn money for your family. $100 may be small to a lot of people. $100 can mean everything to you.
Yeah.
It gives you a shelter, it gives you a roof over your head, pay for your kids' meal, or send them to the hospital if they're sick. So $100 mean a lot to you. But you don't know where to start doing business or going out to work because you got children. So my platform is very simple. You go to my website, you sign up, and in 30 seconds, you're given an entire website that belongs to you. So now you are a beauty entrepreneur. You have a website, you have inventory, you have a whole system including the payment gateway to take orders. All you need to do is post on social media. And any commission that you earn, the business ships direct to the customer, so you never leave home. So you're just banking commission after commission after commission by owning your own business. So our business mission is to make as many women financially independent.
Yeah.
Because we believe when women are happy, they raise happier households and they raise happier children.
True.
Okay, so our mission is 100 years forward. So when I had that mission, I refused to believe anybody tell me it's nothing but a piece of crap. So I told my mother one day, this is going to go global. Today, it is still in my room, in my computer. But one day, the world is going to thank me and say, because of you, I can pay my bills, clear my debt, raise my children, and be happy. And that's where we are now, 3 years down the line. So 18 months, absolutely nothing. I owe my mother so much money, and I thought, I'll never get away with this time. This is worse than bankruptcy. This is like a dungeon you can never get out of. But I believe Rezeki is in the hands of Allah. So it doesn't matter, as long as you show effort, the opportunity will come, and it will come so large. The more you suffer, the larger the reward is going to come.
Yeah.
And it's all a test of nothing but patience, okay? And strong belief. So I believe in myself even when nobody else does. And that is entrepreneur. Okay, you're always going against the current. People call you delusional. But if you believe what they say, then they are right. So I, 18 months later, I was found by a family office who funded $500,000. So that changed the game entirely. So that's where we are. Of course, we raise multiple fundings after that. We continue to grow the business. We invest money to make business.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and I won't fail as I did the last time. Why? Because I learned the lesson from the last time. I'm happy bankruptcy happened. So that's how we got here globally, because we know how to sustain our business and we have the capital and people who believed in us. There will always be more people who don't believe in you than the people who do. But just because you come across people who don't believe in you first, doesn't mean you won't come to the time when you meet someone who do. And all you need is one person. One person with the capital funding, with the belief, with the power, with the authority, with the opportunity. That one person you need to find. And you might have to knock on 100 doors before you find this person. At first you hated it, but when you find this one person, you go, that was worth it. If it's going to take me 18 months of losses and bankruptcy to get to $500,000 capital funding, I'll do it again. That's how I tell myself.